Welcome back. Part two. I'm going to do some heart rate kickers, some body weight work using intervals where we really exert for the working period and then we take some time to rest. We're going to start with a little bit of burnout. So we're going to come on down to the floor and we're going to do some half push-ups. So if you don't feel comfortable doing a push-up, we have many options. Starting out, wrists are going to be under the shoulders and you're going to push away from the floor, activating that upper back. Now, you can do this on your knees by sliding the knees back so that you're at a push-up on your knee position in that angle so that your core is engaged. And when you go down for that push-up, it's going to be elbows going out at a 45-degree angle and then pushing away. So I'm going to be doing the full push-up position. If you want to try, in either case, a slight version of the push-up, you can just literally do a micro push-up, which would be just kind of pushing through the shoulders and then pushing away. So let's go. Down to that half a push-up. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, push away. Take a breath. Let's go down for 2. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, push away. And last one. Really work that back. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, push away. Great. Take a breath. Shake out that upper body. We're going to come up. And we're going to do 3 squat holds. So if you want some support, you can do this on a chair. Squat position. Feet are slightly wider than the hips. And toes are slightly angled out. And your knees are going to point towards those toes. So we're going to sit back with that butt. And hold for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, squeeze to stand up. And we go down, number 2, 4, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Coming up, take a breath. Last one, down for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, stand it up. Shake out the legs. Getting that heart rate working. We're gonna start with going through the exercises. So we're gonna review the first 2, go through those for 2 rounds, and then move forward. So first one, Elaine is gonna be using the chair. So she's gonna go down for 2 squats, and then on that second squat, she's gonna step back and come front. So I'm gonna be doing a long jump, standing up, and then stepping back, and then walking up with the arms. And then exercise number 2, Elaine is gonna be doing a step side to 3 pulses. So she's gonna step side, 3 pulse, and then back to the middle and step to the other side, down for that squat, 3 pulses. And I'm gonna be doing a 3 pulse jack with the legs. You ready? We're gonna try this. So again, we got the 2 squats and then the step back. And then the step side for the 3 squat pulses. And then step to the other side. Ready? Let's go. Kick that heart rate up, burning some of those calories. And we got 15 seconds to breathe. So remember, next one is gonna be, for me, squat jacks with the 3 pulses, and with Elaine, stepping side, 3 pulses. 5 seconds. Let's go. Breathe it out. Burning up those legs. Invite in some of that burn. 7 seconds. Awesome. One more round. Breathe it out. Calm it out. Use this time. Refuel. 5 seconds. Ready? Let's go. Breaking through that mold. 5 seconds. Great, 15 to breathe. Last one with those three pulses. Either you're stepping side or you're jacking with me. Take some deep breaths, you got 5 seconds. Get in that squat position to get it ready, and let's go. Light on the feet, using that core. Working both directions, down and up. 7 seconds. Stay strong. Great. Next one, we're gonna go through the next two exercises. So Elaine is gonna be doing a step side cross jack. And I'm gonna be doing a cross jack active. And then the next one, gonna go down to the floor. And Elaine, this is gonna be kind of working that upper body. So you're gonna be hiking towards the floor with that head to work in that push up. And then you can stretch those hips back into a down dogs, because I'm gonna be doing a fuller pike push up position. If you don't feel like you wanna go all the way down to a down dog, you can just stretch the hips back into a child's pose and then go into that push up. So just to review again, cross jacks or step side, crossing it out, and then doing a pike push-up, working on that upper body. Get it ready, you got 3 seconds. And let's go. Burn it up. Breathe it out. If you need to take a break, totally fine. Just come back. Awesome, coming down to the floor, getting ready for those pike push-ups, either following Elaine on your knees, or you can follow me in that down dog position, working that core, working that upper body, shoulders stay down the back, let's go, push it through. Burn up that upper body, burn up the shoulders. Working that upper back is really good for your posture. Super important for staying upright. Awesome. One more round, coming up. So we're going for those cross jacks again, and then back to those pikes. 6 seconds, take your time, breathe it out. Ready? Let's go. Kicking that heart rate up. Pushing that heart rate burns those calories, burns that energy, burns the stress. Great. Coming down to the floor. Back to those pike push-ups. You got 8 seconds to breathe it out. Get your form ready. Activate through that upper back. Ready? Let's go. Push strong through that upper body, keeping those shoulders down the back. Breathing through, calming out. Great, we're gonna flip over, do some core work with our heart rate work. So Elaine is gonna be doing reverse plank. So she's gonna lift the hips, and then pull those knees in, one at a time. And I'm just gonna be staying in that reverse plank, pulling the knees in. So when you're doing this, if you only wanna just do a small lift, totally fine. You're working those glutes, working that core. And then the next one, last one, if you want something for your head, feel free, put a towel, fold the mat. Tabletop legs, as if you could put something on it. Elaine's gonna reach up and then reach for those knees. So it's upper body crunch, and I'm gonna be reaching up and reaching for the ankles for a little bit deeper of that crunch. So ready, coming up. Again, being careful, you can roll over, push up. And we're gonna use our core and our butt muscles to lift into that reverse plank. 4 seconds. Let's go. So controlling both directions with the legs. And this also uses the arms when you lift, especially the triceps. Always good to engage extra muscles. 3 seconds. Great. Coming down into that tabletop legs. So again, knees above the hips, legs in a tabletop. We're gonna reach into that crunch. Exhale on that crunch. Let's go. Take your time. Using the abdominals, the stomach muscles to lift. Don't strain through the neck. Exhale on that crunch up. Refuel on that release. Awesome. Coming up. Again, if you're worried about coming up, you can always roll onto your side using that top hand, the left hand, to push your body up. Last round here. Let's finish this strong. Ready? So reverse plank. And then pulling those knees in. Pulling that stomach to your spine. Wrapping that corset. Breathe it out. Take your time. Great. Last thing, laying back. Legs in a tabletop. Getting ready with that breath. Getting ready with that corset abs. Engage it before we even start. And let's go. Finish strong. Exhale on that crunch. Lifting those shoulders off the floor. Using stomach muscles, which is really good for the back. Great. Awesome job. Thank you so much. And please come back for part 3. Take care.